got tired of us and we split up after about 6 months.
Of us, both of them?
Well, it's sad. Those early experiences, they help you realise who's really important to you, you know? Family.
So that's this agreement she has with her twin sister. I'm going to proceed thinking twin from now on, unless I start thinking differently, seeing something differently. But I haven't completely discounted the multiple personality dissociative disorder angle. So they have this pact, this agreement to switch out each other and have sex with the same guy. We'll go on dates with the same guy. And pretend they're the actual person. Well, Eve is pretending she's Hannah. Apparently, Hannah's the one with the identity and all this stuff. Hannah's the one who can get married. Eve doesn't have an identity. She legally doesn't exist. So, that's pretty interesting. You know, I wonder if anyone's tried to do that. Of course, fingerprints would be different. I'm assuming they've both been fingerprinted. That's a given. So that would tell us, for sure, who, I'm gonna write that down as a question mark here. Fingerprints, because that will tell us if this is really the same person or not. They're not gonna have the same fingerprints. Twins, even twins don't have the same fingerprints. Oh, so let's ask about Carl then. Coral! We've got 5 entries found. Luckily, we can look at all of them. These are from July 1st. So, these are from July 1st, and this is Hannah. And this is Eve. We watched the one with Eve. So this is before that one. So they seem to put the like ones at least in, you know, chronological order, which is a good thing. Let's watch an Eve one.
Differences?
About Carl.
She's a better driver than me. She passed the test for us.
Okay, she's talking about twin.
I tried to take it and nearly crashed the car. Learned that you can't rely on confidence to get you through everything. She is the shy one. She was especially shy around boys. If Hannah liked a boy, I would have to pursue him. It was that way with Carl. Hannah met him first. She had such a crush.
Hannah's shy.
I let him take my virginity after a night that his band had played at. It got difficult. When I was with Carl, we would have sex, but Hannah couldn't let him see she was a virgin.
Ah.
She had lots of excuses.
Interesting.
After a while, we decided that I should take Hannah's virginity. It's not that different to a bruise, pulling a tooth, a graze. We used a hairbrush.
Damn.
After that, we took it in turns, though. I was always the one who seduced the boys. Until Simon.
Until Simon. Because if I remember correctly, Hannah had sex with Simon first, which was against the agreement that they had. She would seduce the guys and have sex with them, and then Hannah would continue from there when everything was pretty much established. 14, 24, 41, we've watched that one. Alright, so about Carl, this is a little shorter one.
Was he my first? No need to be so coy. No, he wasn't my first. That would have been Carl.
So this is Hannah.
He was a local boy in a band. He was a bit of a shit. everybody was sexy. We were 15.
You can see she is a little shy like that. Because she can't say he's sexy and stuff without laughing like that. She's a little more, you know, bashful kind of thing. So this is pretty
much...
No. Right
after
that. I was
15. Carl was older. I was really into him. Lots. We did it in a half after about 6 months. It was sad. Really important to you, you know? Family.
Okay, so next. Short one.
Family. So, Carl fucked off. And then there were other boys here and there. And then, Simon.
Right. So these are all the entries that mention Carl. So at least at this time there is no more Carl. So this Eric that she mentioned. Got him a present. I don't know who this is. This is a new... That's a new blouse to us. But this is... Hannah. So about Eric.
He was wearing a shirt.
Narrows
blue
it down.
Turtleneck shirt and jeans. He has a watch. It's a really nice one. That was a gift from his boss, Eric.
Simon's boss?
He had his coat. A long grey duffel coat. Black pants there. He would have taken that with him. It's not in the house.
So Eric was Simon's boss.
So, it was Friday evening. We had an argument. He left. On Saturday, he didn't come back. I waited all day. He was supposed to go help Eric out with something on the Saturday afternoon. They had a job. He didn't show. So Eric was ringing on the phone. I checked at The Rock, that's our local. They said they'd seen him on the Friday night, but not since. He still wasn't back this morning. It just isn't like him at all. Still not back by dinner time. It's getting dark again. So I decided to come see you.
Parents haven't heard anything
either.
She went to go see them. The police. Huh.
Yes, there's a car that we share, a Cavalier. And a van he uses for work. It's owned by Eric, but we look after it. Both of them are there now, parked in the street. I'm not sure about the keys for the van. I can look for you when I get back.
Cavalier. Van.
Yes, that would be in his wallet. It's a Visa. A silver one. He doesn't like to spend money he doesn't have, so he usually pays with cash, but Eric convinced him to get one.
And I don't know who this is, but which of them this is, but this is very short.
Eric was like an uncle to him. They were pretty close. They spend a lot of time with each other, especially when they have to go to conferences. Have you met his wife, Diane?
Okay, so Diane is his wife, which I thought has helped him pick out the gift. Did she get punched? Here? June 25th. Because I thought it was makeup, but really it looks like it's on her cheekbone. Like, I don't know. It's very dark.
Eric was like an uncle to him. They were pretty close. They spend a lot of time with each other. Especially when they have to go to conferences. Have you met his...
black eye. We've got one about a black eye. And this is Eve.
If one of us got hurt, the other one would have to be hurt too.
So you both have a black eye.
A bruise. When I lost my tooth first, we had to put our harness to match.
Ow.
Once, I slept with a boy who was seeing another girl. The girlfriend came up to Hannah the next day and punched her in the face, gave her a huge black eye. That night, she had to do the same to me. She almost went too far. I couldn't see out of that eye for days. She snuck frozen peas up for me from the kitchen.
Yum.
So much of our bodies were synchronized anyway. We started our period on the same day. All our childhood diseases, stomach bugs, nits.
Frozen peas, how nice. Alright, so Diane, I don't think she's gonna play a large part. Oh, she has a bunch. Well, she's got a guitar there. What am I gonna say, piano? Here's another one from that session. 1335, 1336. What does she say here again? Oh, you met her.
Eric was like an uncle. Diane.
He met his wife Diane. Okay. What about Diane then?
Diane is really nice. She helps out with the glaziers, organizes the Christmas party, that sort of thing. They have two kids. Really sweet kids. She used to look out for me when I worked there.
I do want to find out about the baby, too. Apparently, Hannah's the one who had the baby? I don't even remember. So this is Hannah.
Not really. He would go to the pub. He had his drinking buddies there, but no one ever really came back to the house. Sometimes Eric, his boss, and his wife would come in for dinner. That would be us returning the favour. Diane is a really good cook, into her trendy ingredients.
Trendy, huh?
And the last time Simon cooked something off MasterChef, he got the recipe off CFAX, and I did my Lloyd Grossman bit, commenting from the sidelines. I had to find fennel from the supermarket. Have you ever eaten fennel?
Can't say I have, and I don't know all these references that she's making. So only 17 seconds, so it's Hannah, right? She's a singer and plays guitar?
Simon and Eric arguing? No, I can't imagine they'd be arguing. They get on so well. Unless it was something to do with work, maybe Simon was being too much of a perfectionist. But I don't know. You should ask Diane.
I wonder if they got... Okay, so these are all the entries about Diane. She did mention a Florence. All five entries. So these are all the entries about Florence. And this is Eve speaking. And what'd she say here? Wedding gifts?
Across the road... When my parents first lived there,
midwife.
There was a midwife called Florence. When Hannah was born, pulled by the cord, told my mother I was dead. She wrote all this stuff in a diary. Amazing what people will admit to on paper.
11:29:32 we ended at. 29:45, 30:15. 33:30, there's a break there, was it? There was a break there. 34, wait. Alright. Alright, more about Florence.
Florence took me home with her. Mother hadn't been expecting twins and had a healthy baby. I guess she was just happy for Florence to clean up. Take away the evidence that this was anything but a happy occasion. Florence took me home with her. Mother hadn't been expecting twins and had a healthy baby. I guess she was just happy for Florence to clean up.
So Florence took her home. Did the mother know?
Florence raised me in her home. I never left it. She kept me out of sight. It wasn't odd for people to see a midwife with a baby, carrying in supplies, washing nappies, that sort of thing. I never knew any different. I grew up looking out of my window and seeing her across the road.
Hannah.
I thought it was like a reflection in the mirror. She was me.
So this is... yeah. Obviously this is a like a momentous kind of occasion here, because the music changed, we got the little darkening here. So continuing.
Florence was a warm, kind person. But she was broken, I guess. When I found her diary, I also found a biscuit tin with other stuff in it. Older papers, letters, that kind of thing. Her story wasn't there.
Her story?
I never really spoke to her about it. I was far too young to really understand. I guess I just put it together later, once I was older. She had loved children, planned to have a large family, but her husband died in the war. And that was back when you married for life. She never felt like she could marry again. Isn't that strange? She was a widow from her 20s.
Wow.
But, I mean, I guess it was different then. You know, you married for life and she felt she could never marry again. I guess it was harder, a war widow. One of the dead. I don't know, maybe there was more to it than that. I don't really know.
And now this one.
No. It was just me and her.
Her and Florence.
It was the name they were going to call their first child. They talked about it and were going to try when he came back. Florence's family had a history of firstborn girls, so they were convinced it was going to be a girl. It's hard to know if this is all true. These are stories I remember that I read when I was a child. Maybe I misread. Maybe I misunderstood. Sometimes it's hard to remember what happened last week.
Interesting. So I wonder when she left Florence and went to go live, what, in the attic with Hannah? When Hannah brought her up frozen peas and stuff? They mentioned Brighton, so I just want to, like, eliminate some of this stuff. Yeah, there's only one about Brighton. Glasgow? There's a bunch. I don't know which one this is. I don't know who's wearing the red.
I got in the car and I drove. I just kept driving north. Just kept going, just wanted to get as far away as I could. When I finally stopped, I was all the way up in Glasgow. I was so tired. I just had to sleep.
So... when Hannah... I think it's Hannah, right? Got the... or Eve got the tattoo. Did Hannah also get the same tattoo? Because that's what they kept doing, right? If one of them got a black eye, the other one had a black eye kind of thing. Or did they separate at some point? Because she went away. Or one of them went away. I don't even know which one this is. Do another one.
Yes. I got to Glasgow. I was exhausted, so I pulled over and slept in a car. I woke up because a rubbish truck went past. I got some petrol, bought a coffee and a pastry, tried calling someone from a payphone, and then headed back.
Wait.
I got in the car and I drove. Just kept going, just one finally stopped way up in Glasgow. I was so... I just had to sleep.
So she slept in the car at that point. Couldn't reach him on the payphone and went back. Did we just watch this one?
Yeah.
The mirror.
That's Simon's watch.
Or the watch.
It was a gift from Eric. He got it this year. He must eliminate me. I was in Glasgow then.
I'm thinking this is Hannah. I'm just not sure. Oh, this is very short, this one.
No, I don't think so. Glasgow was deserted that early in the morning.
Deserted. Any more on that?
When I arrived in Glasgow, I was exhausted. The streets were empty. I was driving badly. And I hit a taxi. Not a big crash, just paintwork. The guy was so pissed off because I didn't have a driving license on me. But when I told him I was pregnant, he made sure I got to the hospital so they could check me out. It was fine. The hospital must have details when I was looked at. There's a scratch on the car.
I'm thinking that's Hannah. Alright. What about... pregnant. Don't know who this is. I don't know which one that is.
I got pregnant. Both our parents had a big powwow. We weren't even in the room. And they decided we should get married.
It's Hannah. Okay, so... the blue... ridged... is Hannah, and I think the one... the red shirt... is Hannah as well. This one.
Yes, I'm fine. Oh, I was sick again. This happens some days. I'm pregnant. This morning sickness.
She's pregnant now. And she was pregnant when they got married. So when is this? June 25th. I'm glad this is all in the same year so far. It makes it June 27th. Wait. 58. Alright, let's continue. Tiny one.
No. Well, yes. He found out on my birthday. I told him I was pregnant.
Sorry guys, I just sneezed. When you hear that sound, that means I'm muting the mic. so you found out she was pregnant.
It's Rapunzel. The story starts when she's born. Mother Gothel, a witch, takes Rapunzel from her parents and keeps her locked up in this tower. Rapunzel gets pregnant by the prince, and Mother Gothel is furious, so she cuts off her hair and throws it. Actually, her hair's already short here, so that's already happened. She throws her into the wilderness, and Rapunzel is reunited with the prince, who's blind. But she kills him with her tears, and so it's a happy ending. Is that too much?
That's not how Rapunzel goes, is it? And then there's this one, which we've already seen.
When I arrived in Glasgow, I was exhausted. The streets were empty. I was driving badly. And I hit a taxi. Not a big crash, just paintwork. I told him I was pregnant. He made sure I got to the hospital so they could check me out. It was fine. The hospital must have details when I was looked at. There's a scratch on the car.
Yeah, how do I get access to... Wait. Oh, that was something... Wait. What's all that? This is... I'm filling this in, right? There was a lot less of these green bits, and there wasn't that... That yellow wasn't there before. Alright, continuing. Now we're searching here. So it's pregnant, 10 entries found, but... Hospital. Okay, so this is... I think that's the one we just watched. 2 seconds?
Ask the hospital.
Ask the hospital. 2106.
When I arrived in Glasgow, I was exhausted.
Yeah.
The hospital must have details when I...
How do we get the details from the hospital? That's not something I can... Query history. Oh, good to know. I don't know. It'd be good to see if we could find... Like, you know, some documents and look at from the hospital and look at them. Now, I haven't looked at this one. It's 8 seconds. This is Hannah, I think.
I don't see how it's hard. We've established I was in Glasgow when he was killed. We've spoken with the hospital.
Okay. So the blue... The other blue is Hannah as well. I haven't spoken with any hospital. Because these are... She's not talking to me. These are old... This is old footage here. Let me... find out about Gladstone Street. Oh, it's just this one. What'd she say about it again?
My name is Hannah. Gladstone Street.
That's where she lives. Or lived. So what's about this... Princess Street? Is also Princess. Hannah.
Yes. Remember where... Probably Park Street. There.
I'm not sure what the question is there, what the context. Okay, what about the body? This is a lot on the body. I guess she sings about the body. Hannah found the body.
The bruise. I have a really fast metabolism, so stuff like that just comes and goes.
Well, the bruise was on the other side for her, though.
I don't know if there's much more that I can tell you that I haven't already told the other policemen. I found the body.
She found the body.
It was after dinner. I had spoken to Sam's parents on the phone. I looked up for an early night and I suddenly had this thought. I think it was something his mother had said. She'd been speaking about old stuff. Sad stuff. About when we lived there. About the baby. There's some boxes in the cellar, nursery stuff. Stuff we never needed and I never had the heart to throw out.
Cellar?
I suddenly remembered that when I'd looked down there the week before, those boxes, that pile was in the wrong place. I went cold all over. I went down there with a torch and went straight to the back. And that's when I saw the bin bags. Pulled them open. Saw the body. I screamed and that's when I called the police.
Mm-hmm. 20:54:02. So that's after... Oh wait, no. This one we just watched, wait. Oh no, it is after that, never mind. And then we've got this one.
His body.
Oh yeah, we've seen this one. Throat.
Glasses.
Glasses were missing. Throat was cut. We've got a song here.
Really? Okay. Here's the rest.
Content ID match.
Anything you sing may be used as evidence against you.